trying to find what is the equation or the regression equation of y on x. We use the same method to come up with the regression of y on x, but let me just take us through very quickly. So you see part 2, we're trying to find y on x. What is our calculation of y on x? We just remember that formula that we have there. So to get this, we usually say y is equals to a plus b of x. And the normal equation for y of x is that the summation of y is equals to n a plus b summation of x. Then the summation of x y will be equal to a the summation of x plus b the summation of x squared. Remember a friend of mine that used to call this sigmas, but instead of using sigma, let's just use the word summation to make things much easier. So let's substitute the values that we have of summation of y. We already have it there from our question. Is 252 is equal to n, the number of variables that exist, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7a plus b, the summation of x, which is 280. Okay, then we have the second equation, the summation of y, the summation of xy, 10,920 equal to a, the summation of x, which is 280, plus what? Plus b, summation of x squared. The summation of x squared in this case is 11,900. What it is? So this now becomes our equation 1. Since they are not very well, you see this letter B here. This letter B, bring it on this other side so that we have an actual number that can be read. Then instead of B 11,920, you say 11,900 B. A also comes with it. That's the same thing that I did here. I just removed this letter B and brought it on the other side. This letter B also brought it on the other side. This 252, the A on this, I brought it on the other side. The same thing I've done here, so that now I have my two simultaneous equations. Now we're supposed to solve those simultaneous equations like we just did here. Therefore, in this case, I'll just give us the since you've already done the substitution, let's look for a value that you can use. Let's also, instead of using elimination method, let's also, instead of using substitution that will take a lot of time, let's use the elimination method. The elimination method. So we want to eliminate A. In this case, the only way you can eliminate A is by multiplying. We have 280 and 70 and 7. So we come and find the matrix, 280 divided by 7. This will give us 40. Okay? Like we did here. That means the whole of equation 1, we multiply it by 40 so that we eliminate A. So 252 multiplied by 40 will be equal to 7 multiplied by 40 plus 280 multiplied by 40. That's the mistake I made previously of not multiplying all two. Then 10,920 be equal to 280, this is an A, plus 11,900, remember this is a B here. Okay, therefore we have 2520. 252 multiplied by 40 will give us 10,080, which will be equal to 7 times 40 will be 280 A plus 20 times 40 Now we can use the one that we had previously, but let's just do it. B, 10,920 equal to 280 A plus 11,900 B. So since you are multiplying 280, what can we do to plus 280 and another 280 to get a zero? Come and say we find out, we subtract the two. So 280A minus 280A will be zero. Then we have 10,800 minus 10,920. This one will give us negative 120. Then we have 11,200 less 11,900. Have negative 700 B. Therefore, you can say negative 120 is equal to negative 700 B. To remain with B on one of those sides, we come and say divided negative 700, negative 700. So we say B is equal to negative 1200 minus, no, 12, 7. So negative and negative goes, that remains 120 divided by 700, which will give us 0.17. 0.17. Okay. Well, value of B becomes 0.40. So we actually made there was an error in the calculation of this point. Where if you say 10,080 less 10,920, you get 840. This 840. So we come to 840 divided by 840. 840 divided by what? 700. And you get 1.2. Therefore, B is 1.2. Then you come and ask ourselves, how do we get A? You say, we come and substitute this value of B into A. 252 will be equal to 7 multiplied by A, and then 280 multiplied by 1.2. So 280. Answer multiplied by 280 will give us 336. 7a plus 336 should give us 252. Therefore, we say 7a will be equal to 336 less 252, which is 84. Divided by 7, divided by 7. Therefore, our a is equal to will be equal to negative 12. Therefore, we come and substitute, we come and say our regression equation was y on x, where we say y is equal to a plus b x. Therefore, we come and substitute the values we received, come and say y is equal to a that we found is negative 12 plus b, which is 1.2x. And now this gives us our second regression equation. This gives us our second regression equation. Okay, that gives us our second regression equation. Now, for the sake of, we really need to also have a question that we'll do for your assignment, and I will therefore take this juncture to actually write it down. Let me write down one of the questions that you will do as part of your assignment. Assignment, say, The same question as this, find the regression equation from the following, calculate y on x and x on y for the following values of x and y. So you're saying your assignment is calculate the regression equations of y on x and x on y for the following data. That is for the following values of x and for the following values of y. Now let's just recap the class before we end up. Since today we learned about regression, we talked about the regression line, the regression equation. We have talked about the regression equation of x on y. And also we've talked about what are the normal equations. We've also talked about the regression equation of x on y, and we've talked about how one the independent variable now changes from y to x. And then we've done an example in class where we've talked about we've calculated the first regression equation and the second regression equation using the elimination method, and we see we can either use the elimination method or the substitution method because these are simultaneous equations. These are simultaneous equations, which I believe most of you did in your high school. Yeah. So you remember there are a number of ways that are used to calculate simultaneous equations. Usually have the elimination method or the substitution method. So you use those methods to find to solve the two equations to get a regression line or the regression equation. And finally, you've given us this assignment. We have the assignment where you've been told calculate the regression equations of y on x and x on y for this data. The data that I've given is rather simple. If you can see, mine had a lot of variables, but yours are only 5. That's all for today. Thank you and have a great week ahead.